financial addition is extremely important for any country and any economy. When you look at Pakistan, I mean, more than 50% population is female. And if the country has to progress, you need to actually bring women into the mainstream so that they can contribute towards the economic development. If you look at the stats today, female contributes between 18 to 20% of the GDP, which is significantly less than the potential. And I think going forward, digital and financial inclusion creates opportunities which never existed before. So mobile as a tool for enablement, for socioeconomic development, becomes extremely important. There are many. When you look at the mobile internet penetration, you see that penetration is relatively low. So we are talking about less than 40% penetration in a country like Pakistan. When it comes to financial inclusion, the overall penetration is even less. So 80% of Pakistanis are unbanked. So that remains the overarching barrier. Then there are other factors, for example, literacy being one of the barriers. Adaption of technology could be another barrier, where if people are not literate, I mean, there's a barrier of using technology. And then there could be certain specific social or cultural nuances as well. So in a country like Pakistan, where 70% population lives in rural, one of the barriers is that females are not, in some cases, allowed to go to market, get themselves registered and verified, and get their hands on SIM and handset as such. So we see digital and financial inclusion, especially for female, as the mainstream focus of our organization. Telecoms is a sector of sectors, right? So it enables opportunities across. It's not just about connectivity or financial inclusion. It's about building a digital ecosystem. It's about commerce, health, education, agriculture. And we have many examples of specific initiatives. I'll mention a couple here. First one is a social welfare program, which is called Benazir Income Support Program. It's a social welfare funding, which is channeled through Telenor and a few other partners for millions of female, which lives at the bottom of the pyramid, poverty lines. Second initiative is our Khushal Angan program, which is specific agricultural livestock information services. It talks about, you know, raising the family, nutrition of children, livestock information, and then we have a specific agriculture programs as well. Like you mentioned, agriculture is one of the large sectors of economy, contribute about 22% of GDP, and female workforce is actually more than half who are involved in the agriculture. So just giving them access to information, access to marketplace, weather is changing. And that is bringing a lot of benefits for business as well. Because when it becomes mainstream, that means their usage of data goes up, your usage of services goes up. So it's not just become a social responsibility, it becomes a double bottom line for companies like Telenor. It's been an amazing Mobile World Congress, like every year, I would say. But this year, I think the program, the balance between some of the technology areas, some of the other industry verticals, but also around, you know, the social impact. The topics like privacy, topics like how we can be more inclusive in making sure that dividends of technology are reaching out to every citizen throughout the globe, I think is something which is very well appreciated.